Rosie 501, Michael Rosenauer.
Es gibt ein Hoch auf das, was uns vereint. Auf diese Zeit,
auf diese Zeit.
Ein Hoch auf uns, uns. Auf dieses Leben, auf den Moment, der immer bleibt. Ein Hoch auf uns, uns. Auf jetzt und ewig. Auf einen Tag. Unendlichkeit. Wir haben Flügel, schwören uns ewige Treue.
Einfach wird es nicht für Michael Rosenauer, denn da wartet ein dreimaliger BDO-Weltmeister. Er ist der aktuelle BDO World Champion, spielt seit diesem Jahr auf dem PDC-Circuit, hat schon zwei Turniere gewonnen, stand beim World Matchplay im Halbfinale. Daza Glenn Durant!
Is today going to be the day that sees Glenn Durant pick up his first stage title in the PDC? Threatened, of course, at the Winter Gardens at the World Match Play, has already won a couple on the floor. And the three-time world champion who moved over from the BDO with a fanfare has got perhaps, most would probably say, the most favourable draw in the third round, apart from the fact that this man, Michael Rosenauer, is going to have all the crowd behind him. Second meeting between the pair on the Euro Tour this year, and it was a little bit close for comfort, their first one at the European Darts Open, which does a 1-6-4. But a win here would see him tee up a quarter-final tie with Daryl Gurney. As always in this Sunday afternoon session, it's played in the order of the drawback bracket, so the world number three awaits for the winner of this one. Gurney squeezed past Steve Beaton 6-5 in the previous match. We would be expecting a rather more serene passage for Glenn Durant, wouldn't we, Mark Webster?
Yeah, you'd think so, but we did say that about Christoph Ratajski yesterday when he took on Michael Rosenauer, but too many missed doubles and he afforded too many opportunities to the German, and he punished Christoph.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg, Glenn to throw first. Game on!
I really don't see those luxuries coming his way from Glenn Durant today, who put in an accomplished performance, who was pushed all the way by James Ritson yesterday. I think at four legs, James Ritson was averaging over 110, but Glenn just dealt with the situation, and you'd expect 85. Him to do something similar today.
Richardson, one of four players to average, finish with an average of over 100. Durant was slightly under that.
100.
He will feel hard done by to have only picked up three legs, but that is the relentlessness of this man. An excellent match player. He's got everything, hasn't he, Glenn Durant? Big scoring, combination chips. Holds his nerve. Doesn't seem to buckle under pressure.
60.
Just look at the way he's handled his move over from the BDO. Reaching a final on his first weekend, winning a title on his second, and that's after being up against it at qualifying school as well.
You've only got to look at his seeding for this event.
One
seeding 11 already on the European Tour. Granted, that's with a couple of withdrawals, but he's up there on the Pro Tour to merit his form. Two tournament wins.
92.
And a finalist.
Glenn, you require 102.
Semi-final run in match in Blackpool. They defeated Michael Van Gerwen on the way, so it's been a fantastic year for Glen Durrant. There's plenty of the year left.
Game there's the first combination leg. Finished. We've had the maximum from Dozza.
Michael to throw first.
Showcasing his skills from the start.
100.
And they were the legs that Christopher Tasky threatened yesterday, but was just making a mess at the end, and he let Michael Rose now in. But kudos to Michael Rose now yesterday. Every opportunity given to him, he took.
One man on Fosey.
And he's going to need to take those chances when they come his way. If they come his way today, if he has any chance of progressing into tonight's quarterfinals. As Chris said earlier, Daryl Gurney awaits after another last leg victory, this time against Steve Beaton. Michael Rose now has throw under threat here, ready. So turn behind. Needs a, well, you'd say he needs another treble on this visit.
100.
Lucky with the last one, just catching the fight.
Well,
Durrant in command against the darts. Taken out that 102 in the first leg. He's left himself an even handier checkout in the second.
100. Glenn, you require 64.
So Glenn Durrant, 64. Had a break a throw. Level 16.
32.
So Michael Rose now gets a chance. Only needs one treble in this combination. I feel it's an opportunity he has to take. And he's not going to now. So Glenn will return.
28.
To double his lead and gain firm control.
Glenn requires
this last
32.
16 tie. Is he going to start doing what Christoph? Tyson did yesterday.
86.
Rosenauer will be disappointed that previous visit only left 86 from 114. So still work to do, and he's wayward again. Needs the treble 17. Sloppy dart to Michael Rosenauer.
45.
Surely Glenn won't let him off again.
Glenn requires 16.
Fluffed his lines a bit from that 64. He's had seven darts from there now. Make that eight.
12 scores.
Scrappy stuff from Glenn Durrant, who has let Rosenauer into this leg.
Gifted him the opportunity. Two at double 16 to level up.
Game
and he hits it with his first one. And a similar story from yesterday when he played the Paul Ratajski. Missed doubles. And Michael Rosenauer punishes to level up.
Give the crowd something to cheer.
45.
And yeah, it is true to say that his opponents have squandered 58. Darts that double against him already in the last couple of matches. And I'm only talking two legs into this one. He's seen his opponent miss 30 combined darts at double. But you still have to hit it yourself.
Yeah, of course. I mean, it could have been also different. We saw Mike Bedeck having two darts to lead 5-3 against Michael Rose now in the first round. But he punished the mistakes. As we said, he punished them yesterday. And he's punished the first mistake from Glenn Durrant today.
One man of 40.
Well, Rosie, after 7 years of trying with large gaps in between, has finally made it through to the final day. He's determined to, well, let them enjoy themselves. You're never quite sure whether he's enjoying himself or not. He does have a game face, doesn't he?
He doesn't give a great deal away. It's the first time he's only seen sort of real emotion on that last shot. He was disappointed that the last hour landed so low.
Two big checkouts available. No longer for Glenn.
100. Michael, you require 164,
like he did in the previous leg. It caused him all the problems. He's going to get a go at it. Surely he'll stay.
99.
Treble 16 for the double 64. 8. Or 216s for the double 16. There's the treble. So double 8. Let's move back in front. And again, more missed darting. Glenn Durren.
Yeah, that does not banish the darting demons. In fact, it feeds them. And Rosie
36.
Had the chance to steal again, didn't take it.
Glenn Durren requires 16.
Was offering more gifts in the previous leg. Is he feeling as generous still?
Game shot on the third leg. Glenn Durren.
Well,
full play, Michael to throw first.
Glenn Durren will have felt like he needed that.
Yeah, it was just, I know it's early, it was threatening to get a little bit scrappy for Glenn Durren. He needed that double just to get rid of demons in the previous leg. And you've seen him sort of stare down the double eight when he hit it. I have to say to myself, come on, the game starts now. Because after that opening hold row, it's got a little bit sloppy from there.
One right on 40.
Well, there's the man that Durrant beat yesterday, taking it in.
60.
Better from Glenn Durrant.
One right on 40.
Expected him to find that third one, but was well clear in this leg. Rose now has not done too much damage. Last start saves him a little, but Glenn Durren in control of this leg, as he was in leg two, has to convert.
The crowd not really giving Michael Rose now too much encouragement here. One thing that the German crowds tend to do is respond when they're given something to shout about.
126.
A ripple of applause and a few cheers there, but he's been unable to leave a checkout, so Glenn Durren has half a dozen darts to clean it up, and again, just a scrappy one. It's a loose dart.
Just got to stay straight here and lay up the shot, and that's it.
28.
Awful visit from Glenn Durren. So Rose now out again with a turn. Can put pressure, turn four even better. Wow. And he goes to lead 36. So yet again, a leg Glenn Durren was in complete control of.
Not sure if Michael Rosenauer found a four-leaf clover somewhere en route to this tournament, but he certainly is being handed huge slices of fortune time and time again.
56.
Can he take his chances?
Michael require 36.
Another holder throw.
Game
and he hits it. There's that crowd reaction that you talked about, Chris. Just give them something to shout about. But he's hanging on in there. 11 points difference in the averages. But the main thing is it's 11 and Rose now knows. Keep backing on about yesterday and his first round game. If you just hang in there, the opportunities will come.
Yeah, well, there's one key reason why this match is level, isn't there?
One right on 40.
That's all the darts missed at the outer ring by Glenn Durren. And for Michael Rosenauer, as Meatloaf once said, two out of three ain't bad.
One right on 36.
It is tricky, this game, for Glenn, though. You don't look beyond ties like this, but as you said, because it's a favourable draw, and it's an opportunity you don't want to pass pass by. Just the back end of the legs, Glenn just needs to be a bit more quality, but that's not been the problem in the match. The score and it's the setup and the finishing at the back end of the leg.
41.
Plenty of time on his side to get rid of this 54. 14 for tops.
Game shot.
Hits
the
it first and five legs played. Five legs all on throw.
First game on.
3-2, Glenn Durren leads, and it's halfway to the last eight, and a clash with Super Chin.
60.
It'll be interesting to see if Rosenau came up against Super Chin, because he seems to have this hoodoo against his opponents to somehow make them miss darts at double, but Daryl Gurney has got a record of 12 out of 16 in this event, which is a very, very good return, 75%.
Phenomenal displays from Daryl Gurney in both his matches. Survives a match as he's down in upper, but
one
from 5-4 down here, Steve Beaton, he showed real true grit in that game. Showed why he's the world number three.
Is there a tendency sometimes to underestimate your opponent? Perhaps not be as focused, not be you. I mean, you shouldn't be, should you? But can that happen? Has it happened to you?
I wouldn't say underestimate, but when you get an opportunity like this, because no disrespect to Michael Rosenau, Glenn wouldn't have been expected to be playing Michael Rosenau for the place in the last eight. So he knows what the big opportunity is, and you just got to go up there and do a job. I mean, ideally, you just play your best darts and get rid of the game straight away. But you can see he's having a little think about it. He knows, I wouldn't say he's looked beyond Michael Rosenau, but he knows the game he should win, but he's just allowing himself to get embroiled.
You can look at the opportunity of, particularly on a final day when you might have four matches to play, you can look at, oh, this could be the day, this could be opening up for me, and perhaps take your eye off what's right in front of you.
One up!
As you saw that, Glenn fires in a max, and it
33.
Only to leave 167, also Rosenauer, a treble 18, which he hits.
Glenn, you require 167.
Three darts at tops if Glenn can get rid of the 167.
And he can't. So Rosenauer, who himself has been very, very decent indeed
80.
In terms of doubling,
Marco required
should
40.
Tie this up at three apiece.
Name shot, six leg. Michael Rosenauer, seven leg Glenn to throw first. Game on.
Good leg from Rosenauer. But we touched on these two have played already this year on the Euro Tour, and that was a close encounter. Glenn coming out 6-4 victor, so Glenn will be aware of Rosenau's pedigree.
Yeah, Rosenau's not even playing as well as he did in that match. Although that might be changing. A rapid final dart from Rosenauer to nestle into the treble 20 bed.
His first max of the match, and he just released the last dart really quickly. Had rhythm.
Well, Durant under duress, but not showing any signs of it. Bats back. Fantastic match. Perhaps hasn't had the quality of the one that we've just witnessed between Beaton and Gurney, but we've certainly got darting drama here. And Durant has found some kind of zone.
What a response to the maximum at the beginning of the leg from Rosenauer. Back to back from Glenn Durant. And a possibility of an 11 dart leg.
44.
Yeah, just when Rosenau was threatening to break, Durant fires in. Six perfect darts, mid-leg, takes his maximum tally up to five for this tie.
Give
the last dart, just not really happening for him on that double eight.
Well, that has been the only chink in the armour. This would be a ton plus average
95
easily if Glenn Durant had sharpened up on the finishing, and he might well be on his way back to the practice room by now.
Definitely just the doubles have been an issue, and they're still proving an issue. Down to double two, this could get messy.
Four score.
Oh,
more chance for Rosenauer.
137.
As you said, those missed doubles that have been costing Glenn. You see his average drop 3-4 points courtesy of those missed doubles.
Is it two tops? That's what he attempted.
I think he was very decisive, was he?
65.
He's an hour in.
Glenn, you require
need it all, really. So Glenn, more opportunities.
Yeah, he has been missing in clutches, Glenn Durrant, and that's the problem. Tidying up combinations or failing to hit at all.
It's really awkward now. Last half for Glenn Durrant.
No score.
He goes in the double 17. So Michael Rosenauer
requires 72.
To hit the front for the first time in the match. 72. Another one of them. Double top. The first break of throw in the match.
32.
Oh, it's just too high.
Glenn, you require four.
Well, surely now Glenn Durrant can put an end to this trend. He's missed 16 darts at double in this match. And now there's no margin for error. No error in the end from Glenn Durrant, but that was by no means a comfortable holder throw.
Oh, well, it should have been, but it wasn't. But kudos to Glenn Durrant. When you missed all those darts at double, the last thing you want is to be going up to double one. But he hits it with his first dart. Goes back in front.
So as we mentioned, the winner of this 40. To take on Daryl Gurney tonight. We've got matches coming up between Ricky Evans and Nathan Aspinall. Gerwin Price, the defending champion, plays Joe Mernon. Peter Wright against Mensah Suljovic. What a tie that could be. Adrian Lewis against Johnny Clayton. Joe Cullen still without luggage against Rob Cross. And Richard North against Steve West in a battle between two unseeded players. As Durrant looks to pile in a six maximum. And he does that.
7-180s in the match, six for Glenn Durrant. But that's not been the problem. Still back. Sorry, Chris. 59. I think Joe Cullen's stuff has arrived in the last hour or so. So he's got his darts, his shirt, and everything. So he's ready to go this afternoon.
Well, he did beat Michael van Gerwen in the final last week. And he flew here on a Dutch airline, I believe. It seems that they've taken it quite badly. Not the ideal preparation, but he showed some class to contend with the situation that was out of his hands yesterday, Joe Cullen, in beating David Van Bowen, who produced the performance of the first round on Friday.
Yeah, like I said, did a professional job. It was just about getting through last night. It wasn't about how Joe performed. It was just about winning. And he's done that, and he's back with his familiar equipment and familiar shirts.
174!
That should be a cracking encounter with Rob Cross, an opponent who Joe's got a good record against.
58!
What does it? Once again, has given himself shed loads of darts at double. Does he need a shed load?
This is. He doesn't want to go inside. This is where it gets messy at the back end of the leg again.
Game shot in the eighth leg.
And you can see what it means to him. And the first break of throw of the match allows Glenn Durrant now to throw for a place against Super Chin Daryl Gurney in tonight's quarterfinals.
Yeah, well, take a snapshot of that reaction from Glenn Durrant and file it under R for relief. As this has been a struggle in terms of finishing legs off for Duzza, and he's seen what Rosenauer has done in the previous 2 days. He knows that he's capable of getting over the line, but now he has just given himself that bit of breathing space in this match.
And had he missed more doubles there, and it gone 4-all with the finishing line in sight, the doubts would have crept in. That's where the pressure would have mounted on Glenn Durrant, but pinned that double six. And has started this leg well.
95.
Looking good for a place in the next round.
And who knows where he could go from there. He had a fabulous performance at this stage. Last weekend, 110 average in beating Gerwin Price, but he went no further. So who knows, some days you have an off match and then all of a sudden turn it on in the evening.
95.
See, Michael van Gerwen did that on several occasions on the European Tour. Just about winning the first one.
Yeah, and that's what Joe Cullen did last week to clinch his first title. He had a real purple patch
96.
In the last session, the quarterfinal, semis and final. That's where you've got to play your best dart in these Euro Tours. And Glenn will be hoping his best is yet to come.
5. Glenn will require 40.
Well, the fitting way to win would be to miss a few and then hit in the end. But that's a great guide for him to seal the deal here. And that's what does it does. Glenn Durrant moves through. Not without trials and tribulations, but he sees off Michael Rosenauer for the second time on the Euro Tour. In 2019, and Durrant goes through to face Gurney in what could be a belter of a quarter-final here to Risa. Durrant wins 6-3, books his place in the final session. We're going to hear from Glenn in a moment, and then we'll be back with Ricky Evans against Nathan Aspinall, the UK Open champ.
Rosi, 5-1, hat alles gegeben. Es hat heute dann doch nicht ganz gereicht. Aber so ist das, wenn du gegen einen dreimaligen Weltmeister spielst. Glenn, congratulations. It was a different game compared to yesterday, huh?
Yeah, I'm not so happy. Absolutely very happy to get through to the quarterfinal, but I felt very good. It's a, you know, it's a fantastic throw. The crowd are amazing, but I wasn't there today. And, you know, to play Daryl Gurney, I'm going to have to play a lot better than that.
Yeah. And when the doubles are not working, you need patience. You know, that makes it difficult.
My strength is my doubles. Yeah. And, yeah, it's a very frustrating game. I don't mean to be miserable after a win. But, yeah, a little angry because I felt so good. And Michael's a real legend of German darts. And I wanted to put a fantastic show on, but yeah, a win, but I'm happy.
Yeah. Yesterday we started with our German lesson. This time it's, you are the best, ihr seid die Besten. Ihr seid die Besten.
Ihr seid die Besten!
Glenn Durrant!
Thank you very much.